Ladies and gentlemen, it's a matter of great privilege for me now to invite for the address Right Honorable Prime Minister of Nepal, Sushil Koirala, to the podium.
Mr. Chairman, Chair of the Administration, Honorable Distinguished Speakers, Honorable Excellencies, Distinguished Participants, Ladies and Gentlemen, good morning to everyone. It is indeed a great privilege for the government of Nepal to host 8 international conference on community-based adaptation in Kathmandu. At the outset, I would like to extend a warm welcome to all the distinguished participants, including those who have traveled from far away, ran all the way to Kathmandu. And delighted to speak a few words at this opening ceremony of the content attended by climate scientists, adaptation experts, and finance professionals and practitioners. I believe the conference will provide useful platform to share and learn from each other on the way to adopt and build resilience to adverse impact of climate change. Climate change has emerged as a defining issue of our time. There has been irreversible degradation of ecosystem affecting our life support system. Global warming and climate change are said to be posing existential threats to human survival. Several reports and studies warn that warming of climate system is unequivocal, and the impact of climate change on natural and human system is all but missing. It is sad to know that the vulnerable section of our society, particularly the poor and marginalized communities, are left to bear the brunt of climate change, but no fault of theirs. This is based on precedent. Nepal is an important location in terms of balance of regional ecosystem of South Asia. And we are not immune from the changes in our climate system. We have experienced climate-induced extreme events like rapid melting of glaciers, shifting weather patterns, high floods, extended droughts, loss of biodiversity and depletion of water sources. These changes have been exerting immense pressure on the rights and livelihoods of the poor and climate vulnerable to people. These steps of countries, including Nepal, which have contributed least to greenhouse gas emissions and at least capable of adaptation, are the worst victim of climate change. Adverse and disproportionate effects of climate change have severely undermined our development in the world, reversing the development gains achieved over the years and pushing already poor people to the brink of extreme poverty. I am aware that many countries around the world are facing similar problems, and no country remains immune from the effect of climate change. Global problems require global solutions, calling for a concerted and unified effort of all stakeholders at all levels, local, national, regional, and global. This would respect the fundamentals of common but differentiated responsibility for sustainable development, outcome as we commit ourselves the task of creating an order of construction, creation, and secure future for future generations. We in Nepal are passing through the process of democratic transition. At present, we are engaged in laying the foundation of political tourism based on the universal values of democracy, human rights, and fundamental freedom, good governance, and the rule of law. This primary lesson and herald new era of peace, establishment, democracy, and prosperity in Nepal. Climate change has received top priority in Nepal. The fact that the climate change commission has been established under the chair of the Prime Minister is a clear testimony to our strong political commitment to climate change. We have put in place necessary legislative and policy framework to deal with climate change and related activities. We are implementing climate change policy and are focusing on strengthening our institution and coordination mechanism. Efforts are underway in implementing the most urgent and immediate climate adaptation action to a framework on local adaptation plan for action. Now, and a separate climate change budget for tracking public expenditure. We are also in the process of developing a low carbon economic development initiative. I believe our efforts will provide direction for future course of action towards helping the poor and climate vulnerable communities adopt the adverse impact of climate change. Generating awareness in local communities, especially the most vulnerable among them, of the adverse impact of climate change and enhancing their capacity to adapt to climate change and improve their livelihood should constitute the core of community-based adaptation effort, where available community development, best practices can be scaled and shared widely, including through the integration of such practices into national development plan and policy. Nepal has been leading the LDC group at the UN climate change negotiation. We are thankful to all LDCs for their continuous support in articulating and defending the collective rights of the group. We also thank all the countries that have contributed to the LDC Fund, Adaptation Fund, and Green Climate Fund to support the LDC in their effort on developing adaptive capacity and building resilience to climate change impact. However, what is available is not enough. Moreover, climate financing should not compromise financing regular development activities. It should be additional. The international community, particularly the rich countries, should assume global responsibility and fulfill their commitment. We also call for a balanced approach between adaptation and mitigation. Resources going to adaptation should be enhanced to help prevent climate-related disasters in poor countries. Their support in implementing local adaptation plans and promoting low-carbon economic development path in the LDCs and other developing countries is critical. We are of the view that the process of accessing the fund by parties need to be simplified and streamlined, and the LDC must be supported to build their capacity in confronting the challenges. We call for greater international cooperation and commitment for reducing greenhouse gas emissions and increasing local community adaptive capacity. the four of them additional predictable and sustained funding, as well as ask for appropriate and reliable technology is vital for this. As we discuss the progress in implementation of Millennium Development Goals, subscribe ourselves to Sustainable Development Goals set out by Rio Plus 20 and for an acceptable post-2015 development framework, we call for a better and productive partnership between developed and developing countries. The role of resources is critical in realizing our goals. This meeting is discussing ways to secure climate finance for the poor and climate vulnerable communities to adopt the adverse impact of climate change. It is also important because its output should fit into the climate summit schedule for September 2015 in New York, which is hoped to generate the necessary political will to achieve an ambitious, fair and effective climate agreement in 2015. The international community, especially the major players, must exhibit recognized political will in this regard. Further delay in reaching a concrete global deal on this crucial issue will be detrimental to humankind as a whole beyond comprehension. Let me conclude with the quote from Mahatma Gandhi. He said, and I quote, "Earth provides enough to satisfy every man's need, but not every man's greed." End of quote. Let us sacrifice our personal greed in favor of larger need of prosperity. I thank the co-sponsor and partner of supporting us in hosting the conference. I wish the conference a grand success and wish the international participants a comfortable and memorable stay in Nepal. Thank you very much.